Connection Science is this research program that includes analytics for social good, things like the Sustainable Development Goals, and trust data is how do you build systems that protect privacy and give you measurements of the Sustainable Development Goals. So trust data actually builds prototype software, and Connection Science has a sister effort which is doing the science needed to do that. So what we do is we build pre-standard software to help governments around the world and large companies to be able to handle their data in a way that protects privacy and is much more secure, much more transparent and accountable. And now we're doing the next generation, which includes blockchain and AI and IoT and all those sorts of things to try to help countries, companies figure out what to do. So one of the things that's unique about connection science and trust data is that we're social scientists and statisticians and computer scientists. A signature project of ours is called Open Algorithms. So what this is a way of making sure that AI is applied to data in a way that it respects privacy, is interpretable, is auditable. And we build example software and develop new analytics methods that protect privacy and are far more secure than previous methods. So the thing that motivates the OPAL, Open Algorithms project, is that there's this explosion of data. There's data about everything, everywhere. And of course that's important to be able to make cell phones work and payment systems and track infectious diseases and make the traffic run on time. But it's very scary too. I started the discussion at Davos at the World Economic Forum to try and address this and figure out if there's a win-win-win solution. And that discussion fortunately turned into the European privacy law. So the privacy law gives people rights over their data. And what we're doing within that framework is we're doing various projects to demonstrate the power of it to drive adoption. So for instance, I'm on the board of the UN's Sustainable Development Global Partnership for Data. And through that, we're using this framework to try and map poverty, map inequality, map other things that are part of the Sustainable Development Goals around the world. We do a fairly substantial number of national scale systems. We're actually building things for entire countries to help them with poverty, with development, with inequality. And it's not just developing countries that we work for. So that gives us access to the central mechanisms of government and helping them do their job better. You say, well, okay, so why do we need to incorporate that in government systems and civil systems? And the reason is, frankly, that the way the world works today is being driven by things like the census, which happens once every 10 years. The world changes so fast, though, that by the time you get to the next census, it's way out of date. And when you use these other sort of data sets, things that are out there, but are currently not used for the public good, like for instance, telco data or bank data, you can begin producing things that are like the census, say once a week, for very low cost. And that's transformative because suddenly you can see if your government policy is working. And if you can make that data public, then all the different parties in the country can look at the same data and decide if they think things are going correctly or if there needs to be a change. And so what that does is that makes the grounds for a much more productive discussion among the different parts of society. We can do things like figure out whether policies are causing people to become richer or poorer. We can see whether they're causing social stress, which has all sorts of bad effects, or not. We can map places where there's much more likely to be segregation. And so that's really transforming the discussion, because now you can talk about this in a way that's never been possible before. But there's another thing that's happening that's perhaps even more profound, and that is that the law and the government is becoming digital. And people are very scared about this. Algorithms and controls, robot overlords, etc. And so what we're working to do is to make this something that's very human-centric. So an overarching sort of vision of where we're going is something that I call the human strategy. And it's a question of where does AI and data and IoT and all of those things fit in the human framework? Because we'd like this to be a human society. And so it's incumbent on us and our generation to be able to guide this towards a human-centered solution. And so we have to deal with all the sort of moral questions and applications and think about how do we want to design our society to make use of these tools and yet remain human. And we say, well, why don't we just not do that? That would be a response to that. We're demonstrably not very good at talking about how do we address these global challenges. So we need better tools to do that. And, you know, who's going to do that? Well, we all have to do it. And that's something that we're focused on.